Wofford. Thank you, Mayor Kenny. Thank you, Todd. I did not expect this at all. I'm simply a co-chair, and we're testing people for COVID, which is what we've been doing since April. So when I was in fifth through eighth grade, I went to Fiddler Academic Plus School, which is like Germantown, North Philly area. And we used to have a Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King oratorical contest every year. So we were 10, 11, 12, reciting, "I Have a Dream," every year. And I don't think I possess anything that has my name and the Reverend Dr. King's picture. And so that award is very meaningful to me. Because of him, I can stand here. Because of all he gave, the ultimate sacrifice, because he believed that the lives of Black people are important, that they should be treated fairly with equity, and that it was a grave injustice, particularly in healthcare. And so, to be a physician, to be a woman physician, to be a Black woman physician, I can honestly say would not have been possible without the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. And so, it was an honor to be asked to be a co-chair to participate, but even greater to receive that award. So thank you so very much. Completely unexpected. Completely. So I'm excited, you know, campaign of service, January 18th. I'm usually here every year with my sorority, Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated. We were here last year helping with the neonatal unit at Temple University, giving out gifts and cards to young mothers and children. And so this year is different. And so when Todd reached out and said, "How can we do it differently?" we really had to anticipate the weather and social distancing and still providing service, but keeping everyone safe. And we're obviously still in the middle of a pandemic. And so it only made sense that that's what we would focus on. And so I'm excited to be doing that with the Black Doctors COVID-19 Consortium and University of Pennsylvania physicians and Children's Hospital of Philadelphia doctors and people from everywhere. And as I looked at all the sponsors on here, so many of these people have been a part of making the Black Doctors COVID-19 Consortium. So Enon was the second church we went to April 20th, 2020, and we tested 400 people, and the positivity rate was 24% that day. And I remember how many people were sick and waiting for us. This is really horrible. Independence and Lorena Marshall Blake and Dan Hulferty, and I'm forgetting Steve's last name, they were the first ones to give us any money to get started. The first ones. Without knowing what we were going to blossom into. The Urban League sent us people, kids that needed jobs. Of course, Commissioner Farley, we communicate now by text because we need each other's support. Drexel, when they put out that paper that said that there were 6 times more testing locations in affluent white neighborhoods than in Black neighborhoods, people started to pay attention. That was on April 6th, I'll never forget that. The United Way, of course, Global Citizen, but then Global Citizen nationally. Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, Neural Arts, the Enquirer, the media has been phenomenal to us. It's because of all of you guys that CNN and BBC and NPR know who we are. So thank you for doing that. So, and WURD, I've worked it out. I guess, If I had to say something to the citizens of Philadelphia, I would say, thank you for supporting us. You didn't know me. But what I wanted to impart, and I still want to, is that your health and your well-being matters to me. And I saw a need that you weren't getting. And after 23 years of being a physician, I was now in a place to bring it to you. And I realized that the hospitals were strapped, taking care of everyone, and bureaucratic challenges, but as an independent private doc, we could do something about it. And we would not be successful if you hadn't put your trust in us. So it's a two-way street. And so on the 18th, we'll have as many heaters as we can to keep people as warm as we can if you walk. If you're in your car, we'll be able to test you. And we'll be here. And I've said many times, we are here for you, the city of Philadelphia, as long as you need us. There is nothing else that matters. I love this city, and it just means more than you know to me. To receive this, to be a part of it, to be able to give back to a community that I love so much. So, thank you.